I still remember my frustrations the day that my maths teacher introduced me to the number E with that horrible definition on the board. This could have been avoided by talking about investing money. When you visualize concepts and understand them, you can go deep into the mathematics. For example, the Pythagoras theorem, a squared plus b squared equals c squared, makes more sense if you draw squares using the sides of your right-angled triangle. By putting together the smaller areas, you get the big square. Take this quadratic equation. Why do you complete the square, and what does it really mean anyway? You could use areas to visualize the terms of your equation. Once you understand the technique, you can use it to prove the quadratic formula. This factorizing formula will make little sense to you and to most of us, by the way, unless you take your time to visualize the difference of the cubes using volumes by dragging the little cube inside the big one. We are left with the difference x cubed minus y cubed. Hi everyone, my name is Raquel. I love traveling and mathematics, so I have combined both hobbies teaching maths across international schools. The question that I have heard the most while teaching is why? And if you, like me, are not satisfied with simply plugging numbers and applying algorithms but won't need to know the why behind, this channel is for you. The videos are organized in different playlists, and I will leave you with two of my favorite ones. Happy learning, everyone!